Hello everyone, how are you all doing this Tuesday afternoon? I hope that you are all having a wonderful and blessed Tuesday. So we have more and more cities that are planning to pay residents a significant amount of money each month. And in this video, I will be discussing how you could be receiving additional money from President Joe Biden's $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan. So welcome back to my channel, everyone. This is your daily news report and stimulus check update. I want to say thank you so much for being here. I will always be here to answer any stimulus check questions that you may have, so feel free to leave any questions in the comment section below. About 159 million economic impact payments totaling over $376 billion have gone out to eligible Americans in the last month. But according to a new survey that was just released, the majority of that stimulus money continues to be spent on groceries, rent, and other necessary bills. Even those among the highest households earning more than $80,000 or more annually are continuing to struggle because of this crisis, with nearly half saying that they will spend their check on basic necessities. A chief financial analyst at Bankrate recently reported, more than 40% of households are earning less now than they did prior to this crisis. And while that's highest among lower income households, higher income households have not been immune from that. More than half of the jobs lost last year have been recovered, but there are still nearly 10 million jobs that have disappeared that have not yet come back. There are still 18 million Americans still drawing some form of unemployment compensation. A current survey shows that 6 in 10 Americans believe that the $1,400 won't last them longer than 3 months, while 34% says the extra funds won't even last them 1 month. So what are your thoughts on this, everyone? Please leave them in the comment section below. It is just so terrible how stimulus checks are barely helping Americans right now. And it is very clear that a large number of Americans are going to use or have already used their stimulus money just to pay basic needs. If our lawmakers do not pass another round of stimulus checks, millions of Americans will continue to struggle and go hungry. But there is definitely hope, everyone. We have multiple senators who have urged the Biden administration to include recurring relief payments and automatic unemployment insurance extensions in the Build Back Better plan. Last month, the senators wrote in a letter, "While we are pleased that the American Rescue Plan included a one-time direct payment and extension of federal unemployment insurance programs, a single direct payment will not last long for most families. And we are worried about the cliff facing unemployed workers when the unemployment insurance extensions expire on September 6th. The crisis is far from over, and families deserve certainty that they can put food on the table and keep a roof over their heads." I definitely agree with these senators. One stimulus check every couple of months is not going to help Americans. We need recurring payments, and we need it to be passed. So a Chicago alderman is pressing ahead this week with his plans for a guaranteed basic income program in the city of Chicago. This is similar to the mayor of Los Angeles' plan to provide $1,000 a month, no strings attached, to thousands of low-income households. Gilbert Villegas is a Chicago alderman that wants to use $30 million in federal pandemic recovery money to pay up to 5,000 Chicagoans $500 per month for a year. To qualify, applicants would need to have an annual income of 300% or less of the federal poverty level, which Villegas said works to about $38,640 for a single person and $52,260 for two people. They also would need to be enrolled in city colleges of Chicago themselves or have a dependent who is enrolled in city colleges or Chicago public school, or is too young to be in elementary school. I would love to hear your thoughts on these new guaranteed basic income programs, everyone. I know some of you support this while others don't. Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Relief is also on its way for those who have fallen behind on rent during this crisis. There is now more than $45 billion in rental assistance available, thanks to President Biden's $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan. To qualify for rental assistance, at least one member in your household has to be eligible for unemployment benefits or attest in writing that they've lost income or incurred significant expenses due to the pandemic. You will also need to demonstrate a risk of homelessness, which may include a pass-through rent or utility notice. In addition, your income level for 2020 cannot exceed 80% of your area's median income. those states have been directed to prioritize applicants who fall at 50% or lower, as well as those who have been out of work for more than 90 days. Many of these programs don't have restrictions on the amount of funds you can receive. Instead, there will be a cap on how many months of rent you can get. Some of these programs allow for 12 months of housing payments. Others may offer funding for as many as 18 months of rent. So if you are worried about being evicted, then please definitely apply for the funds so that you may receive additional relief. So everyone, that is the end of the video for now. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. I'll do my very best to answer any questions that you may have. And don't forget to enter the $75 Amazon gift card giveaway by subscribing to my channel, sharing and liking this video, and leaving a comment below. Thank you so much, everyone, and have a very, very blessed day.
The retail sales number, it's funny that this 9.8% month to month is actually a little bit lighter than some of the whisper numbers we'd heard. Some of the high frequency data suggested maybe we'd be in double digits. One reason why that may not be true is the stimulus checks, more of them went out in the second half of the month. So that suggests that we could have additional strength in the months ahead.
Some opportunities still within retail. You know, if you look at a TJX, it hasn't fully participated with the market. They've been suffering from store closures in Europe, but I think that's all temporary. And really, as we start to see reopening happen more meaningfully, it is a place where I think people who love to shop will gravitate to. They should have exceptional inventory quality this time around, given there's been so many disruptions. So that's the type of name that we think will continue to work and continues to represent an opportunity.
That they added 50 million prime customers. So you want to talk about retail, this is the whole ball game right here. Amazon told Jeff Bezos in his last letter as CEO this morning, which everyone should read as soon as the show is over, obviously, but should just told us 28% of Prime users are buying something in less than 3 minutes or less when they hit the site.
It is now back on track to grow at 10% rate over where it was in 19. So it's bigger and growing effectively at a faster rate, which is interesting. And if you look in the first part of April, that growth rate continues. So that bodes well for the recovery as long as the vaccine virus track continues on, and as long as people get vaccinated and economies open. You're seeing, even before that happens, you know, through March and now through the first couple weeks in April, you're seeing the growth at a 10% plus rate, which is very strong.
If they've got money to spend, to your point, savings rates are still very, very high. Plus, you've got these new stimulus checks that are filling up their bank accounts. And so they've got money to spend. Where are they going to spend it? I think it's where they haven't spent it, that pent-up demand area.